The roadside people who live their life beside the roads, near the railways, under the bridge, and extra variety of places. Basically, this type of people came from villages. Some of them escaped from their own house, and some people were evicted from their family members.
They are currently living in footpath, and these people making money get into work, like driving auto rickshaw, van, etc. They work all the day and sleep in the night at footpath.
So now the question is, these young and old guys, how to survive their life until the last breath? For these homeless people, government provided the home, and this type of home calls the shelter for urban homeless people. In a short form, SUH. With this in mind, at the direction of the Supreme Court, a survey was conducted in 2011. After the survey, when the report came out, they observed that there were 72,000 such people in the Kolkata. Food, clothes, and shelter are necessary things to needed for survive. At that time, the idea of making the shelter homes was considered with the inspiration of the Supreme Court. This is exactly there is a shelter for urban homeless people located in Satkori Banerjee Road, Malancho Mahinagar, at the South 24 Pargana. The name of the shelter for urban homeless is Nivedita Bhavan. This Bhavan has 4 stories. Ground floor has a big kitchen and a dining space with a big television screen. Then the first floor for women, second floor for men, and third floor for couple. Here all things are available, like improved water supply, a small maintained garden, and a poultry farm.
By survey, we rescue them. We rescue them by out reliable source. And if anybody give us news, we rescue them from under the tree, auto stand, bus stand. First we ask them that whatever they want to come. If their mental condition 85% okay, then we make able to bring out shelter home.
In this lovely home, the meal was provided to these rescued family members that prepared in the kitchen. The food was cooked by the female chef. This woman treated with them like her own child, and for that everybody loves her very much. And not only that, every single person of this shelter home called her Ma. The food arrangement here are very well, and everything from breakfast to dinner is available. When I came here for first time and saw them, I was fall in love with them and thought that if you give them little love, they can take it as their own. For last 2.5 years, I am here with them. I live my family life for 26 to 27 years and have seen this man life. Really, them soul are pure soul. And they make me uncomfortable is that you eat a little too, so I can't live without them.
We started a poultry, little small poultry, so that we can provide eggs to them, and we cultivate fruits, so that we don't have to buy it from the market. So that is, we are also in small scale we are trying. And last but not the least, we also try to provide the people who are living there some to engage with them in some livelihood activities. We have a agarbatti making machine which they produce and we sell with our outlets and local shops. The shelter is purely no drinking, no smoking zone, and there is no visitors allowed also. You know, there is no separate manpower for bathroom cleanliness, shelter cleanliness. So the inmates, those who are living there, they themselves clean their own toilets, houses, and they themselves wash their clothes, bed sheets, rugs, combos, mosquito nets, etc. Pillow covers, pillows.
CCTV cameras have been set up for their security, so that unwanted people can't enter and do any illegal things with these people here. Here all facilities are available, including mineral water, fire extinguisher and submersible pump.
At this very moment, we have 37 to 38 boarders. And different boarders have different type of medical problem. If it is domicilially manageable, then we get the medical support at our shelter. I personally also visited many times there and treated the patient. Sometimes I advised for admission in any hospital.
At the last moment, these people leading a gentle, peaceful, healthy life with no more arguments and complaints. They help each other and living happily. Here I am good as well, not being eaten at home. My surrounding knowing person bring me here and now I am leading far better life. I have no family. My husband left me for another woman and present days he is living with her in Kerala.
ও বাড়িতে গেলাম, শ্বশুর বাড়িতে থাকার পরে ছেলে হলো, তারপরে ও আবার পুনরায় একটা মেয়ে নিয়ে কেরালা চলে গেছে।
My name is Reshmi Bhakta. I am from Kolkata and I am participating in this virtual competition and I am making a documentary film. My documentary is about rescuing urban homeless people and after rescuing them, what happened with them and their lifestyle.